Hi everyone! A week ago I released my first indie game on Steam, Sublunar. Please check it out if you like. Here's 5 things I wish I'd done before releasing it. Number 5. Infrastructure. I released my game on all Steam's supported platforms, Mac, Windows, and Linux, even though I have only a Mac myself. So I was going into the release just knowing that Godot was able to export it for all platforms, and I had verified that it started on the other platforms, but otherwise lived on the assumption that if it worked on Mac, it should work on the other two. It would have been nice to have been able to test it more thoroughly on all platforms. Now at least, I have a virtual Windows machine set up so I can verify the game properly when doing patches. Number 4. Achievements. I was obsessed with trophies on PlayStation for a while in the past, but didn't think people bothered with them on Steam. Just a couple of days after the release, I had multiple people requesting the addition of achievements in the game. Curious about how to implement them, if nothing else, I released an update with 20 achievements to the game on Friday, and got many positive responses, and can see that people are completing them. Feels great to add more value to the game anyhow. Number 3. Curators, streamers, and communities. Since the release, I've been contacted a lot by these three groups. Curators want to get a free copy to review, streamers want a copy to be able to play the game on Twitch, and communities want a couple of copies to give away to their followers. This sounded great at first, and many who asked I obliged. But after doing so, I haven't heard back from most of them, and haven't seen much result at all. Not sure what the best strategy is. Maybe it's right to give away copies to as many people as possible, but it would have been nice to have more of a strategy and have at least enough keys requested to go around. Number 2. Tracking. After releasing the game, I could see that people were buying it, but had no way of knowing if they actually played it, how much they played, where they got stuck, or if the game was crashing. All which would be super helpful to know in order to improve the game. Of course you get some of that in Steam's analytics tools, but not enough. I've always added tracking to my mobile app projects, but didn't invest time into understanding how to do so in a game context. After adding the achievements, however, I have at least some sort of sense that people are progressing in the game. It might be good enough for now. Number 1. External playtesting. Sure, I did some. Mostly I played it myself and determined user experience problem that way, of course knowing that it's not optimal. I had my wife play it, I had my friends play it, and I got some good feedback from them, but the game would still have issues that I wasn't really aware of when releasing it. The feedback I got from people who bought it was mostly about thinking the interface was complicated and misunderstanding core concepts. Now, a week later, I have fixed most of these issues and I feel a lot more confident about the game, but would probably have been able to catch most of these before the release if I had put more effort into outside playtesting, or even listening more to my friends and wife's feedback and not simply trusted my gut. This is something I always seem to neglect during a project. Maybe it's because I'm a bit insecure about the game, maybe I don't know where to find people willing to test it out, or maybe I'm lazy. Maybe you can relate. Either way, next game I'm making it a priority to listen more closely to feedback, even if it might be difficult to hear. That is the list. Hope it will help someone consider these points before releasing their own game. I certainly will when developing my next game. If you have more insight into any of these points, please share them in the comment section. Thanks for watching.